Hello, I'm Piotr Bogucki. I'm UX designer at CodiLime, and today I would like to talk about the product discovery process. My presentation will be divided into four sections. First, I will explain what product discovery is. We will then talk about the process, followed by the things to consider when applying the product discovery to your development pipeline. And finally, we will shortly discuss the next steps. Let's begin by talking about what product discovery is. In short, it's a process that enables you to understand customers and develop a digital product that perfectly suits their needs. We try to understand the real user problems to review or refine our ideas, sometimes redefine the product so that we can land on the best solution for the users. The standard process for prioritizing what the delivery team works on looks like this. We have a strategic vision with lots of ideas. We pass it on to the product team that defines the backlog for the developers. The users get the product, and only then do we actually get the feedback and ideas. What if we invested more in researching and validating ideas upfront, before we even start the delivery? This extra pathway for validation of ideas is called product discovery. As mentioned before, product discovery is a process that helps product teams refine their ideas by deeply understanding real user problems and then landing on the best way to solve them. Even better if it simultaneously provides unique, unexpected value that facilitates daily interaction or eliminates the need for it altogether. Discovery is part of the product design phase. If you don't accurately validate your assumptions about your customers, you'll probably waste time creating an application that nobody needs, as well as waste your effort, resources, and money. Product discovery is often defined in contrast with product delivery. It's the work that you do to make decisions about what to build. On the other hand, product delivery is all about the building, shipping, and maintenance of a quality product. Now, let's see if it's necessary. Well, there is always uncertainty when making product decisions. Product discovery is more of an outcome-based process rather than output-based one. We're not focusing on features and enhancements, but on searching for opportunities for the project to be successful. This approach allows us to save money in the long run while pinpointing a money-making solution. The software discovery process is crucial when you are expanding your business by launching new products or services, developing new product, or upgrading existing products by adding new features. Andrew Chen, a leader of Uber's rider-side growth team, once said that growth is about proving or disproving a fundamental thesis. The product discovery process is important because it helps product discovery teams build the functionalities that are necessary to solve the customer's deep needs. To create such products, you have to collect enough data to disprove or prove your assumptions. Now, let's see what are the main goals that we want to achieve by applying a successful product discovery process. Cutting corners with user research may turn out to be a very expensive risk. Your software product shouldn't be reduced to gambling on assumptions. Product discovery is a useful validation of whether your application really needs to exist, and it allows you to save money and time. It makes your application more innovative as you incorporate user viewpoints from the very beginning of the development process. And it makes the lives of product designers and developers easier. They avoid spending time building a product nobody needs. Now, let's talk about the process itself. First, you need to understand the purpose of a new feature or a product and the problem it solves. The goal is determined by your specific case. It can be a feature concerning one part of functionality or the whole product. The idea is to present the team with the desired outcome, success criteria, and methods to use it. Of course, other people can still, and in most cases, should contribute. The number of product discovery team members depends on the project's complexity and company size. The product trio collaborates to choose the right decision and direction and define common goal. They contribute a variety of perspectives and play a vital part in solving user problems. They interview customers together and, at the end of the day, execute assumption tests to make a good product discovery decisions. The product discovery team usually uses agile and lean methods to make quick decisions on what to build and to verify assumptions along the way. In the next section, we'll focus more on agile product discovery. Do not forget that if you work on a network product or application, the product owner should have an extensive background in networks. That knowledge becomes crucial every time input or verification of designs is needed. Whether it's as simple as just making sure all input fields and variables are part of a firewall design process, or as complicated as helping designers figure out a complicated flow for server provisioning. Accompany that with their pinpoint knowledge of product goals, and you have yourself the perfect link between business and design. Let's imagine we are planning to implement a new feature. To approach the goal statement, you must define a list of critical questions that challenge your idea and suggest initial assumptions that to be tested further. For example, does the user need this feature? What value will it bring? Which problems does it solve? If we remove this feature, what will it change? Do we have the resource to build it, etc.? The more questions you ask, the better. As answering these questions with assumptions and testing the hypotheses will reduce uncertainty in later stages. But it's important to note that discovery should result in outcomes, not features and technical solutions. In practice, these can be understanding of the value or user personas or KPI. Nothing can guarantee the success of your software product. However, some techniques can be extremely helpful in our product discovery. There are many methods to choose from and different techniques depending on the project. While planning the activities, things you should include are user research methods. These involve studying user problems, needs, and behaviors through surveys, interviews, and focus groups. Then there's market research methods, which is focused on gathering information about potential end users and their preferences. We also have secondary research methods. These would include gathering information that already exists in books, reports, papers, and databases. And lastly, there are other methods like design thinking or lean startup methods. Design thinking is an approach often used in creating new products. It's about gathering data about the target audience's needs and producing creative ideas to meet them. This technique is mostly focused on finding a solution that is desirable for a human perspective, and at the same time, viable technically and financially. Lean startup methods are used to reduce waste within business. They give a holistic view of the organization and let you analyze how different aspects influence each other. You can address your product directly to user problems. Now, the design thinking became a basic concept and framework for conducting product discovery. It's a customer-centered approach to analyzing the product requirements. Three primary elements shape the whole idea. Desirability shows demand for a certain feature by target audience. Then there's feasibility or technical possibilities as your company's skills and resources. And then viability, or what makes sense for your business model. This diagram demonstrates the steps in design thinking, which are similar to the process described above. The only difference is the interpretation of the exploration phase. Now, let's go through our full discovery process that is covered in four steps. The first step is team alignment. It's made during the initial phase of product discovery. During a kickoff meeting, you discuss the needs of the project and develop a common understanding of the problem. You make sure all the stakeholders are on the same page. At this stage, you also validate your product idea and conduct competitive analysis. The second step is user research. It is getting to know your target audience and collecting data to test if assumptions are right or wrong. To perform user research, you can use empathy maps, interviews, surveys, user journey maps. There are two types of data you need to gather, quantitative and qualitative. Well, this step is critical for the following activities, as it allows us to synthesize information, gives us directions and recommendations, so we can progress to prototype and tests. Now we can create mock-up to gather the first customer feedback. End users are the only people who can tell you whether your idea is valuable enough to progress to product delivery. While prototyping and testing, try to stay agile. For example, use A-B testing that will help you quickly see whether an idea is worth continuing with. Don't forget that this is still an experimentation stage. You just narrow down the best solutions to the problems you have identified earlier. When this stage of product discovery is complete, your design team should have a clear view of how a real user would feel when using the end product. The last step is refinement. Now let's be honest, no project is immune to crisis and risk. If you want to create a useful software product, sometimes you have to move back and forth to align your user needs with business goals. Very often, it is necessary to take a few steps back and check what went wrong during previous phases. When the refinement stage is over, you move directly to product delivery. Although it's a very rare occurrence, you might need to pivot your idea if the research shows you're likely to provide users with a product that does not meet their needs. Now, let's take a look at Opportunity Solutions Tree that lays out the process in more detail and how it links vision and strategy with real actions, in our case, releases of features. Goal of the product is derived from general vision and strategy. It defines the desired outcomes, how the product will solve user needs and its business environment. This phase is called strategy. Now we dive deeper into the discovery phase. The specific outcomes can be divided into opportunities for our product, with multiple ways the product can approach and use the opportunity. We run through different ideas and validate them. That way some ideas might get discarded, but that way we refine our solution. After all the ideas have been evaluated and reviewed, we can start the delivery phase. Those validated ideas can be distilled into specific features, as in epics, that need to be divided into separate smaller stories that are deliverable by development team. In the end, specific sections of the vision and strategy can be achieved in incremental releases of new features. Now I want to quickly mention things that we need to keep in mind to achieve a successful discovery process. Let's do this by looking at the mistakes one might make. First, let's talk about jumping to solutions right away without enough user research. Understanding user needs is the most important step when it comes to building an app. However, it still happens that product discovery teams are too eager to jump to solution without unearthing the user's problems first. The question, when is enough, comes up often. In short, the user research phase is, in most cases, ends when there is a clear and common understanding of the user needs among the product team. The understanding should be based on real data with as few assumptions as possible. Another one is not involving software engineers early enough. If you only bring engineers into the fold during the delivery stage, you are too late. Software engineers do not participate in the process of defining the problem, won't be able to fully grasp it. They will be two steps behind, which leads to misunderstandings. Another thing is that software engineers may provide valuable technical insights. Next one, involving too many people. Sure, two heads are better than one, but it's important to strike a balance in deciding who's responsible for each part of the process. The more perspectives you include, the slower making decisions is. In consequence, you may end up with a large team moving too slowly. Not having the right mindset. Approaching the product discovery process requires the right mindset. You need a sharp focus on market trends to understand the user problems and needs. In addition, you and anyone else on the team shouldn't be afraid of asking questions. And lastly, separating the discovery and delivery teams. The discovery and delivery processes shouldn't be separated. If so, one group of people does the innovation while the rest just implement it. Every product team should be involved in both discovery and delivery, which guarantees efficient knowledge transfer and makes it easier to come up with new ideas. Once the product discovery process is complete, you can move to the next stage, product development. That involves building a minimum viable product. While this is the end of the product discovery stage, it is vital that the discovery process is continuous and runs in parallel with delivery. This is called continuous product discovery, and it's a great way to maintain the right heading for the product. Event-based metric tools such as Amplitude or Pendo can help with monitoring the usage and experience of the users, informing of ways to improve their experience, easing the path to success, and showing the opportunities within the process. Continuous discovery is a great way to keep the product relevant for years to come as needs and technologies change. We need to keep a keen eye on the environment of our product to remain competitive. This is all that I wanted to cover today. You can check out our website at codiline.com for more content regarding UX in network products. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel to see new videos similar to this one. Thank you and goodbye.